Hello class 11th students, here I am present with a new video, Why I Like the Hospital. I have already completed the first poem, that is Abhisara, the Tryst, and I think you must have completed the question answers which I had given you in that poem. Now I am attaching the answer here of those, okay, and I am giving the link in the description box. Just open it and go through the answers. Obviously, it is your duty to check it whether you have correctly done it or not. And yes, also write me in the comment box how many questions you have done correctly. It's my promise to you that we will complete the journey in a very effective manner according to your examination point of view. And don't forget to like and subscribe the channel. Also write in the comment how you like the video and whatever the things more you require from me. Just listen the poem and after this I will again giving you the questions regarding your examination point of view, maximum number of MCQ questions as well as short answer type questions which you will definitely answer on your own, and then I will give the answers in the next video. Now, let's begin with this poem. This poem is written by Tony Hoagland. He was an American poet, and this poem has been taken from his collection of poetry, Turn Up the Ocean. About the poem, this poem is about the pain and suffering experienced by the patients when they are admitted to the hospital. You know, the poet explores the loneliness and how they count their days when someone is admitted to the hospital. Every day when they are busy in their day-to-day life, maybe they are not getting time to introspect. Introspect means apne andar jhankna. Alright? Khud ko analyze karna. But when somehow they are admitted in hospital, they can introspect their whole life because they are free there. They are free from worldly things. Day-to-day busy life. Okay, so the good and bad things they have admitted in their in the time when they are in the hospital, whatever the deeds they have gone through throughout their life, they can introspect that. So this poem is just about that. In this poem, the poet satires the apathy. Apathy means the pain of the near and dear ones, of the patients, and as well as the present day. He also mocks at the present day healthcare system. You know, when you can see, when you go to the hospital, you will see a huge amount of bills has to be paid by the patients. So he just take it as a satire, and hospitals are becoming simply a source of making profits. So this poem is all about these things. Now listen the first stanza. Because it is all right to be in a bad mood there, slouching along through the underground garage, riding wordlessly on the elevator with the other customers, staring at the closed beige doors like a prison wall. So here poet confesses here that it is acceptable to be in a bad mood when you are in a hospital, because generally the atmosphere of the hospital is not happy. When a person goes to a hospital, there is something serious. Okay, so after reading these lines, you will get an image of a person who is slouching, means moving very slowly and drooping body, like just like this person you are seeing on the screen. You will find a person in this posture when he is not feeling well, maybe because of illness or fatigue, or any of his dear one is admitted in the hospital. So this shows the internal agony and grief of the person also. So this is a general picture of a hospital. And when riding wordlessly on the elevator through the underground garage, means whenever you enter in the parking space, you can see that many hospitals, there is the parking space which is underground or in the basement. So generally When you enter the hospital, your car goes to directly to the garage, and from there you get the lifts. So similarly, when visitors ride silently in the lift with other visitors, as the person who is in the it is such like a situation that there are many pupils, many visitors who are going on the elevator, on the lift. Okay, and now everybody are looking at each other, but they are not acquainted with each other. They are not familiar with each other. So they just see them and go. So all are silent in the lift and gazing silently at the doors of the hospital. Now, color of the door is taken here, beige. This is also a symbolic, which is a very dull color. Beige is a very dull color. And why the poet has used this color? As it goes appropriate with the dull mood of the patient. Like the patient, when he enters in the hospital, obviously he is not in a good mood because he is having some health problem or health issues. So when a person is having some health ailments or problems, he will in a very dull state of mind. So this color appropriately goes with this. Now here the hospital doors are compared with a prison wall. You can see that it is compared with a prison wall. That means why the poet has written there? Because the hospital doors are confined and restricted there. Because the patients are confined and restricted there. They are not free to move. Here is a metaphorical meaning also of this prison wall, that maybe the patient is getting imprisoned by his diseases. Okay, because the person who is having disease, any kind of disease, or is having any kind of fever, they are restricted to some extent. Just like if you have fever, your mother will say, okay, don't eat this, don't do this, and don't go there. Just beware and lie on your bed. So you are confined and restricted to a certain extent. So similarly here, the patients are also comparing the doors of the hospital with a prison wall, as if they are feeling that they are confined and restricted inside the hospital. Clear? Now come to the next para. I like the hospital for the way it grants permission for pathos. Pathos means pity, sorrow. Okay. So here the poet says that he likes the hospital because it allows the patients for deep emotions. Means if a person is sorrowful, no one is going to suppress his feelings. The atmosphere of hospital is such that everyone knows that they are in a grief or in some pain. So no one's grief is looking out of the way there. Now the mother with cancer deciding how to tell her kids. Now the poet is seeing, poet has seen a mother who was a cancer patient, and she is trying to find out the way how she could tell this sorrowful news to her kids. So see the pathos and the pain in the mother's heart, that she is having cancer, which is a deadly disease, and she knows that maybe she will survive for a few days or few months, and how she could convey this message to her kids. Next is the bald girl gazing downward at the shunt. Bald means the girl who was not having hair. Okay, so you will see that there is a treatment in a cancer patients. They have to go through a treatment which is called chemotherapy, and which is this therapy. Whenever the person undergoes this therapy, there is a lot of hair fall. So most of the pupil, all the hair is lost. So they become bald. So that means this girl is also having cancer, and bald girl gazing downwards at the shunt. She is looking at her shunt. Now what is shunt? I will discuss now. Installed above her missing breast. That means this shows that she was having a breast cancer, and her one breast has been removed after operation. And this shunt is a small pipe which is installed into the body so that the extra fluid should come out. Okay, so this is a operational procedure. So in these lines the poet has described the situation of cancer patients, different type of cancer patients. Maybe he had seen the cancer ward there, and different types of patients pain, grief and sorrow he is discussing in these lines. Next, the crone in her pajamas. Crone means an old woman. So the old woman, the next patient he had seen was an old woman walking with an IV pole. IV pole is, you will see that whenever the person goes in the hospital, often they used to give the fluid with this IV pole. Okay, so she was walking with an IV pole. Maybe she was sent somewhere for some test diagnosis also. So I don't like the smell of antiseptic. What things the poet described here which he doesn't like? That is the smell of antiseptics. Many times I also feel very bad with these antiseptics in the hospital, you know, and many people see whenever you enter the hospital there is a peculiar type of antiseptic, means it may be a phenyl or a Dettol. So you will see, which is a very bad, it gives a ditto feeling of hospital. So this is, I don't like the smell of antiseptic. Here the poet also describes here. On the air conditioning set on high all night, or the fresh flowers tossed into the waste basket. The second thing which he doesn't like, that is the air conditioner set on high all night. Means every time there is the air conditioners are moving on. So you will feel very chilled. Sometimes you feel shivering in the hospital, because generally in the hospitals you will see that the air conditioners are moving and 24/7 they are on. So the second thing, the first thing, that the smell of antiseptic, these lines are very important for your MCQs. The first thing which the poet doesn't like, that is the smell of the antiseptic. The second is the air conditioning set on high all night. And the third thing is the fresh flowers tossed into the waste basket. What is this? The fresh flowers means many people, when they come to the hospital to meet their dear ones, they bring fresh flowers with them. And the next day you will see those fresh flowers are thrown into the waste basket. So this is the third thing which he doesn't like. Now you will see here which figure of a speech is here. This is clearly fresh flowers. So alliteration is used here. Now coming to the next para. But I like the way some pupil on their plastic chairs break out a notebook and invent a complex scoring system. In these lines, the poet says which things he likes about the hospital. In the previous, just before these lines, you will see that he has discussed about those things which he doesn't like about the hospital. That was the antiseptic smell and the air conditioning all the time moving on. The next thing is the fresh flowers are tossed in the waste basket. But now, in these lines, he is discussing about the things which he likes about the hospital. I like the way some pupil on their plastic chairs. Now he is seeing some pupil are sitting in the plastic chairs. Maybe they are waiting for something. Break out a notebook. They are having a notebook in their hand and invent a complex scoring system. And they are writing something in their notebook. To tally up their days on earth. What they are writing? This is the time when they have got enough time for self-reflection. This is called a type of introspection, when you can turn yourself towards insight. Okay, means you can see whatever the things you have done, they were good for you or bad for you. Because it gives a chance to the patients to contemplate about their lives. Okay, which they do not get time in their busy schedule. When you are out from the hospital, you are busy in your day-to-day life. Maybe you are doing some job, some work or something, anything. You are busy in that life. You are not getting time to think upon yourself. The things which you have done, they were good or bad. But this is the time when you are inside the hospital. There is nothing. You are out from the outside. You are just away from the outside world. Now you have enough time to introspect yourself. So this time the hospital provides you. So here you can see the poet is having some positive things also. Okay, this is called a positive thinking, that maybe you are ill, you are admitted in the hospital, but how you can take that time positively, that you get time for yourself. Now you can introspect yourself, whatever the things you have done in your past, they were good for you. So the line says, the column on the left that says time I acted like a fool. So on the left side he has written the things which he has done foolishly in his life. The things, the act which he think that he was not wise enough. Facing the column on the right that says times I acted like a saint. And on the next right side he is writing those things where he can say that he acted wisely, just like the saints. So see in these lines that how positively the poet has taken these things, though they are very simple, but if you think upon them, they are great things, that how you can introspect yourself and how you can become more perfect in your future. Okay, by seeing your past, that whatever the things you have done bad, you can overcome from those guilts, you can overcome from those mistakes of your life by seeing them. Similarly, in the next lines, the poet also describes the things which he like about the hospital. I like the long prairie of waiting, the forced intimacy of the self with the self. Here, the poet says that he likes the long prairie. Prairie means here queue. Now, you might have seen the prairies, which are the tall grasslands. Okay. So, here, metaphor is used. Figure of a speech, metaphor is used. Here, the poet has compared the patient who are standing in a queue. They might be waiting for their turn to come, or they are waiting for the appointment with the doctor. So they are standing in a queue. It has been compared with the prairie, the grasslands, the tall grasslands of the waiting, and they are waiting for their turns to come. The forced intimacy of the self with the self. Now here forced intimacy means the forced relationship, means every person, each person who is standing in the queue, they are standing with their self. Again, they are getting time to introspect. They are alone there with their self only. Each sixth person standing in the middle of a field, like a tree wondering what happened to the forest. Now here again, each sick person standing in the middle of a field, it shows how he feels inside. Okay, the person who is sick and who is standing in that row in a hospital, he feels himself as if he is standing alone in the middle field. Like a tree, just like the trees are standing in a vast prairies, okay, in a vast grasslands. What happened to the forest? Now, like a tree wondering what happened to the forest, and they can introspect that what had happened to them. Here the forest is the outer world or the hospital. So see, the beautifully visual imagery has been created by the poet here, that each person is standing there and they are alone with themselves. They are wondering what had happened with them. Now see the last line, like a tree wondering what happened to the forest. This is simile is being used here, because each person, each sick person is being compared just like a tree. And once I saw a man in a lime green dressing gown. You might have seen when you go to the hospital that people are given green color dress. Often when they are admitted to the hospital, or if they are to be taken for any surgery or any operation, so they are being given to put on those green color dress. Okay, so here this is again a visual imagery. And once I saw a man, what he had saw? He saw a man who was dressing in a lime green gown, hunched over in a chair. A man who was not yelling at the doctor. Now how he was behaving there? He was not shouting at the doctor, or pretending to be strong, or making a murmured phone calls to his wife. He was neither making phone calls to his wife and give her solace that I am okay, I am feeling better. Or he was not pretending. Pretending means giving a false look that I am okay, I am strong, I am well enough. He is not doing these things because he was in pain, he was in grief, out of physical pain maybe it is, or maybe a state when somebody is going inside the surgery operation theater for a surgery. They know that they don't know what is going to happen, whether they will come back or not. These type of mixed type of feelings come at that time in the minds of the patient. So here the poet beautifully has described those feelings, those emotions, how a person feels when he is going inside the operation theater. He is allowed to show these things. He is neither shouting at the doctors. He is in a very low condition. He is very confused whether he will come back or not. So he is not pretending to be strong. He doesn't want to show himself that he is strong enough. Okay, I am very well. No, he allows himself to be in a sad mood. He allows himself to cry. But one sobbing without shame. Now how he is weeping? He is not weeping in a very loud voice. He is sobbing. Sobbing means in a जैसे आपने देखा होगा बहुत ही धीरे धीरे आंसुओं के साथ रोना. So he is sobbing without shame and he is not feeling shame that if the people are looking at me, how they will react. Okay, many times it is seen that people do not want to show their tears because they feel ashamed that I am strong enough, why should I feel show my tears. So here he is sobbing and without shame, that is also pumping it all out from the bottom of the self. What he is pumping out? He was trying to pumping out all the pain, all the grief, whatever is in their heart. Which type of emotions at the time you can feel he was having? Maybe he was feeling that he is not going to come out of the operation theater. He will not be able to see his dear ones again. So such kind of things he was trying to take out from the bottom of the heart by weeping. The overflowing bilge of helplessness and rage, a man no longer expecting to be saved. These are the things, means he was in anger, he was in overflowing bilge means his tears were coming out of his eyes. Of helplessness, he was feeling helplessness because he cannot run away from this situation. He has to face out the situation. He was feeling helpless, and rage means he was in anger, he was in frustration. A man no longer expecting to be saved, and he was having this type of feeling that maybe he will not come out from the operation theater. He is not going to survive the next moment. But if you looked, you could see that he was holding his own hand in sympathy. Now again, this is a positive thinking which the poet tries to arouse here. If you looked, you could see what he is looking at the patient, that he was holding his own hand in sympathy. He was having sympathy with oneself. Again, this is a kind of introspection. Okay, listening to every single word. Now he is listening to every single word of whom? Of himself. These thoughts, everything was inside his heart. Everything was going inside his mind. Okay, उसके अपने ही दिमाग में ये सारी बातें चल रही है और जिसको बहुत ध्यान से सुन रहा है. He was listening to every single word. He is the speaker and he is the listener of his own words. And he was telling himself everything, means he is talking to oneself that okay, everything will be fine. This is also an auditory imagery here, because auditory means he was these lines listening to every single word. So in the final lines, the poet tries to say that as if the doctors had told him that he is having some serious illness, some serious disease. So he know this, and this suggests that the man knew that his illness was serious and he did not expect it to be saved. He had to suffer and die alone. Now let's discuss about the figure of speech. When I was discussing the poem, I have already discussed many of the figure of speech between the lines. Now in a very clearly I am going to explain you each, right? So see, the first figure of a speech is used here, alliteration. Alliteration means it is a repetition of consonant sound words. Now see the lines, girl gazing downward. The second is, I like the long prairies. I have underlined the consonant words which you can see clearly in the lines, like the like L and long L. So these are the same repetition. These are the examples of alliteration. Third is fresh flowers, self with the self, making a murmured call. And you know why the poet used these type of figure of a speech? Because it gives emphasis on whatever the poet tries to convey the message. So playing an emphasis or giving an emphasis to the thoughts of the poet, this figure of a speech is used. The next figure of a speech is simile. Simile, as you know, I have already discussed many times, that it is the comparison between two things by using as or like. So the lines, the closed beige doors like a prison wall. Here the poet has compared the closed beige doors, the doors of the hospital, with a prison wall. Second is, like a tree wandering, what happened to the forest. These are the examples of simile. Now next figure of a speech is metaphor. Metaphor is a figure of a speech in which comparison, it is also a comparison just like a simile, between two different things, but that is not clearly stated. Okay, in the simile you will find like and as, these words are used for giving comparison, but metaphor means it is directly stating those things. Which figure of a speech means how, where you will find the metaphor. If you know, so you can write in the comment. Okay, I know you can find out. The metaphor is here, I like the long prairie of the waiting. Okay, now next is imagery. Here the poet has used many imageries. Okay, there are many types of imageries. First is visual imagery. Visual imagery is the visual descriptions of the hospital. All right, now find out the sentences which gives you a visual impact. Means by reading those sentences, a visual image comes in front of you. Just like, I can give you a very good example. Like, I have created the videos of these poem just to give you a visual imagery. Okay, means while reading the poem, you are listening the explanations, that is auditory imagery, and along with that you are also getting the pictures, just like a movie is going on in front of you. So this is called visual imagery. So by using these methods, the learning becomes best. All right, so next is visual imagery. Now see the lines which are giving this. First is slouching along through the underground garage. Next, the bald girl gazing down at her shunt. Again, you can also write some examples in the comment. Just try it out before my speech is going on to you. The next is the crone in her pajamas. Each sick person standing in the middle of a field. Next, you can also try staring at the closed beige doors like a prisoner wall. And yes, of course, but if you looked, you could see. So you will see that when you read these poems, the image of these things come in front of your eyes. The second type of imagery is olfactory. Olfactory is associated with the smell. If your nose means, it is the senses of your smell. You can understand about which line I am talking? Yes, very good. I don't like the smell of antiseptic. So this is an example of olfactory, means the smell. It enhances your smell sense. The next is auditory imagery. I will discuss about the auditory. Auditory means the things which you can hear. Okay, it is related to your listening sense. Very clearly, you can see that riding wordlessly on the elevator. There is a sound of elevator, means the person, the patients who are not talking to anyone. So this is an example of auditory imagery. Next is listening to every single word. So whenever there is a sound coming, that is auditory imagery. Now let's discuss the most important thing, that is the theme of this poem. The first theme is human suffering and pain. Here the poet discussed the physical and emotional sufferings of every human who undergoes through any type of ailment or disease. Whether it is a cancer-stricken mother or a woman who is a victim of breast cancer, or when the poet talks about an old lady who is walking with IV pole. So these all the things give an impression that how the people who are admitted in the hospital undergo such drastic pain and suffering. The second theme is apathy and loneliness. So you see the poem is based on loneliness of patients when they are inside the hospital. The poet is confined inside hospital. He feels that he is confined, he is restricted, his movement and his everything is confined, means it is restricted inside the hospital, just like the prisoners feel in the cell. When a person who is standing in a row waiting for his turn to come feels standing alone like a tree in a vast prairies. So these line gives the feelings of the patient, how lonely they feel inside the hospital. Next theme could be self-reflection. In the hospital, pupils get time to introspect themselves, which they may not get in their busy schedule. Man who was sitting in a chair and making list of his past deeds, which he did wisely or foolishly. This is called an act of introspection, when you can see within yourself whatever you have done in your life, whether it was good or bad, whether it is a positive attribute or a negative attribute, these things which you can calculate. But when you are alone or you are sitting with yourself, you can introspect yourself. Okay, so this is the time when people get time inside the hospital, away from their busy life, to self-introspect. The next is self-compassion. The man sobbing openly, not feel ashamed of his crying. He is compassionate for himself at the time when he is holding his hand and tries to console himself. Okay, so he is the person who has a sympathy with himself. He tries to console that okay, everything is fine with him, or whether he is going to die or not, he is feeling compassionate for himself. Means he is the listener of his own thoughts. Okay, so these are the points which you can beautifully describe as a theme of the poem. Right, so with this I have completed this poem also. Now, for your convenience, I am adding the question section here. Okay, so just see the link. I am adding the link here of the questions. What you have to do, you have to read the questions and try to answer on your own. Alright, the answer of these I will attach in my next video. By then, you just go through the poem and try to answer on your own. This will definitely help you for getting very good marks in your exam. And I have tried to give you many questions from the point of view of the poem. My questions are from simple to complex ones. Okay, it is from easy to difficult level. Many type of questions can come regarding the figure of a speech, regarding the theme of the poem, and as though it is a very simple poem by reading, but when you go through the questions, you will see that how difficult questions can be made from this poem also, which the examiners are making nowadays. Plus, if you are having any problem in any regarding this poem or anything, you can ask me in the comment section. I will definitely try to answer your questions and okay, try to solve. Now I will add, as I told you, that I will give the answers in my next video. By then, bye to everyone.